Lieutenant, the starfish check report is now due.
Commander, the starfish check report is now due.
Very well. Prepare the initial search message and initiate a communication site check. I'll call the Commodore and request permission to continue the submiss checkoff.
Aye, sir. Chief, let's get the starfish's position.
Aye, sir.
Commodore, starfish check report is now overdue. We do not believe it to be a communications problem. Request permission to continue the submiss countdown.
Starfish is operating in area Sierra 8.
Aye, sir.
Best latitude.
Chief Young, recall all staff members on the submiss checkoff list.
Commander, the execution message is ready for release.
Very well. Send this message, Flash President, CW and voice.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Hamilton, notify the Search and Rescue Center and request an air search.
Aye, sir. All units proceed to latitude 20-50 north, longitude 156-45.
This net, this net. How do you read me? Over. Any unit, any unit.
All
this
units,
net. How do you read me? Over.
Bridge com have completed searching on a 5-mile scale. Request permission to search on a 20-mile scale.
Very well. Permission granted to search on the 20-mile scale.
Comet I.
Alpha period.
Any unit, any unit. This net. How do you read
at 0800, the submarine Starfish was scheduled to surface. Now, 15 minutes later, there's been no communication. The search operation is triggered. All available units head for the area where the submarine is believed down. Among them, an ASR, keystone of the Navy's submarine rescue operations, whose officers and men have the experience needed to tackle this emergency without delay.
Captain, the last known position of the submarine was right here. Here's where we are. Recommend course 045.
Officer deck, come right to course 045. Increase speed to flank.
Aye, sir.
Right full rudder, ahead flank.
Right full rudder, head flank. That's the head flank, sir. Runners right full.
Station of 4-point mooring detail, rigging phase.
Boats mate?
Aye, sir.
That's the word. Station of 4-point mooring detail, phase one, rigging phase.
Aye, sir. Now set the 4-point mooring detail.
Phase one, rigging.
The operation as a whole includes three phases, rigging, mooring, and the rescue itself. While the vessel is en route to the scene, the rigging phase is being carried out. Color-coded nylon line is faked out on deck for each leg of the moor. The submarine rescue chamber, the ASR's principal tool in submarine rescue, is made ready by two crewmen who will operate it. Airlines, light, and telephone connections are checked. The operators are themselves deep sea divers, thoroughly familiar with the maze of valves, vents, and other controls that govern the buoyancy and movement of the rescue chamber. At the estimated site of the casualty, the area is combed, both above and beneath the surface, for some sign or message from the submarine. Rigging has to be assembled for the moor. Chain is hauled out of the locker. Each length is connected to one of the four anchors hanging ready in their hawse pipes. The other end is connected to one of the spuds. Every available man joins the lookout. There it is, a red flare from the sunken submarine.
Starfish, this is Pelican. I have sighted your flare and am closing you at this time.
Pelican, this is Starfish. I am unable to surface. Break. I hold you bearing 220, 7,000 yards from me. Over.
Starfish, this is Pelican. Request you release your messenger boy. Over.
Pelican, this is Starfish. Roger, out.
The submarine located, the rescue operation begins. This buoy brings up a 7/16 inch stainless steel cable that will be the submarine's lifeline during the rescue operation.
I hold the buoy bearing 045, about 1,500 yards, sir.
Starfish, this is Pelican. My boat is coming in to plumb your marker buoy. Interrogative, your heading and condition. Over.
Pelican, this is Starfish. My heading is 072. I have 2 degrees down low with 1 degree port miss. I have all ballast tanks flooded. Over.
This is Pelican. Roger. Over.
The ASR's captain selects the axis of his moor by judging direction of wind and current.
Lay out a racetrack moor with a center axis 040. And we'll lay it on a 500-yard radius.
The ASR will move in a broad rectangular course around the ship's boat that is its reference point, dropping its anchors and spuds at predetermined points, marking range and bearing precisely by radar. Within an hour and a half, all 4 points of the moor have been set. The last leg is dropped pre-connected to the nylon surface line, and the ship moves into position above the submarine. The hawser handling boat, with its radar reflector mast, is sent out to plumb the cable, pulling it taut to fix the point directly above the submarine. The ASR will next fix itself in this position by means of a multi-point moor, using the radar reflector mast for ranges and bearings.
Now set the 4-point moor in detail. Phase 2, mooring.
Now the first stop will be the starboard side.
Now all hands stand clear of starboard side.
Bearing.
023, 600 yards.
Hold your 40 yards left of track, recommend course 054.
Come right to 054.
Spuds and anchors ready. Men are standing by to lay the first leg of the moor. The ship's radar offers a continual reading of ranges and bearings, which are checked visually from the bridge.
Bearing.
012540 yards.
Hold your 20 yards left of track. Recommend course 068, 200 yards to the drop.
Stand by starboard, drop on the whistle.
Right full rudder, come right to 068.
All hands stand clear of the starboard side.
Let go starboard.
Will be the port, 500 yards from the
Then nylon surface lines are attached to the other three spuds.
Thank you.
The ship is moved into position above the submarine and sets taut in the moor, with the ship's head in the axis of the moor. Now, the messenger boy from the submarine is hauled on board. The messenger boy's cable is cut, threaded into the rescue chamber, which will be attached to the chamber's downhaul winch. Together with the chamber, the ASR has the divers, the equipment, the deep reserves of air needed to sustain the rescue operation. The diving station is being set up nearby.
Dumbbell locked, six-cock is open, exhaust valve set 2.5 turns. Gonna put you on a stage, put you over the side, check yourself out, swim to your descending line, go to the bottom, take a blow, and check out the submarine.
Together with the chamber operators, every one of the divers aboard the ASR is preparing to join in the highly concentrated effort that lies ahead. A diver goes overboard to examine the cable, foot by foot down its entire length. He must confirm that the cable is free of any sign of weakness and that it is not fouled on the submarine.
Yellow diver, get off the stage and go to the descending line.
Yellow diver, get off the stage and go to your ascending line. Yellow diver, on the descending line.
Yellow diver, going down. Let me know when you reach the bottom.
Yellow diver, leaving the surface. Okay, yellow. Okay, yellow.
Now set the 4-point mooring detail, phase 3, rescue.
The rescue chamber, all 10.5 tons of it, must now be hoisted over the side.
Down by 2. Bring her in.
Movement of this weight requires complex rigging and expert seamanship. Now the operators climb aboard.
Take the slack out of your steady lines and hold them.
The hatch is secured, and they're on their way. This rescue operation is relatively simple, but to put it into practice requires intense and exacting effort.
Starfish, this is Pelican. My bell is in the water. I am commencing my first bell run. It will take approximately 15 minutes for me to make a seal on your deck.
Stop that in the bell. Start to the checklist. Upper hatch closing, dog.
Upper hatch closing, dog.
Lower main balance.
Lower main balance.
Main balance blown.
Main balance blown.
Going down.
Flooded to retain 1,000 pounds of positive buoyancy, the rescue chamber pulls itself down to the submarine by means of an air motor that winds up the cable on a reel. The chamber is approaching the submarine. The operators adjust the attitude of the chamber to the slight list of the submarine. The chamber fits perfectly over the escape hatch, as it was designed to do. To hold the chamber tightly against the submarine, they flood the ballast tanks, blow the chamber's lower compartment, and vent it to normal atmospheric pressure. The pressure of 200 feet of seawater squeezes the chamber's rubber gasket around the hatch, making a firm, tight seal.
Outside in the bell. On the bottom, seal made. unable to communicate with submarine.
Request U.S. submarine status of pressure in the boat. Over.
In the bell, the pressure in the submarine is 14.7 pounds.
Pressure in submarine, 14.7 pounds. Request president to open lower compartment hatch.
Pressure at.
Moving into the lower compartment, the operator first makes the seal mechanically secure by putting holding down rods into place. When bolting down is completed, the chamber becomes an integral part of the submarine. The downhaul cable is slacked off and the fairlead assembly moved out of the way.
No pressure indicated. Hatch all the way open and ventilating submarine.
The hatch is ready. Make your ascent.
The first group of passengers moves up into the rescue chamber and the return trip begins.
Taking six passengers on board.
The procedure for return repeats that of the downward trip.
Closing
the submarine hatch is closed. The fairlead assembly is replaced. The hold down bolts are removed and the lower compartment hatch is closed. Then the lower compartment is flooded and the ballast tank blown. Inside the chamber, the crew is fully protected against exposure to the sea and gross variations in pressure.
Main ballast blown. Seal broken. Leave it at bottom.
Propelled by its 1,000 pounds of positive buoyancy, the chamber rises toward the surface. During the upward trip, the air motor is used only as a brake. Safely aboard the ASR, the chamber takes on more ballast and quickly departs on its second trip. Once again, the operators begin to go through the detailed procedure that will bring them down to the submarine for a second load of passengers. The rescue chamber rides down and back like an undersea elevator until all of the crew have been brought off. The operators have kept alert by constant practice, and they have the skill born of long experience in deep sea diving. They understand the forces prevailing in the depths of the sea, the bypass and backup systems their chamber offers in event of a casualty. The rescue operation moves steadily forward. Each of the Navy's ASRs is equipped with a rescue chamber. Their crews keep a sharp edge on their experience through practice. In this exercise, at 100 feet, a chamber is mating with a false seat, a mock-up of a submarine escape hatch. The deep submergence rescue vessel is the spearhead of new technology that will enable rescuers to work at much greater depths, with greater flexibility, greater speed. With these new devices, must come a broader understanding of the capacity of submarine rescue. Experience has shown that submarine disasters may strike in shallow waters, well within the reach of our current rescue chambers. Experience has proved the rescue system based on the ASR and its chamber is a practical, realistic response. In this effort, those who man the Navy's submarine rescue ships stand ready to give their best.